Hello viewers, welcome to educators.com. In the previous session, we have discussed about WebView and how to enable JavaScript for WebView in our Android layouts. Now in this video, we are going to discuss about how to create a nested layout. Nested layout is nothing but creating a layout inside a layout. So now here, I'm going to show you a small example for that. So in the previous sessions already we discussed about relative layout and linear layout. Now we will see how to create a relative layout inside a linear layout, or maybe how to create a linear layout inside a relative layout. So I'm going to explain you a simple example. So where the parent is your relative layout, by default when you create your project, it would be relative layout. Inside that, I'm going to create a small login page kind of thing. So where you'll have a text view for name labeling and the corresponding edit view, edit text and user password and the corresponding text and two buttons for like login and cancel. So the first two, I'm going to take it with a linear layout where within horizontal orientation. So one text view and edit text will be side by side. So I'm going to take the orientation as horizontal and for the last, I'm going to take it as a relative layout. Now let's start with Android Studio, create a project and let us see how to create a nested layout. So create a project and name it as inner layout or nested layouts. So click on next, choose your main SDK. So choose your template and click on finish button. So let's wait until unless the project loads. The project has been created. Now open your activity layout file. So defaultly we have one text view. The parent is with relative layout. Now I'm going to create as we discussed. I'm going to have an edit label for your username and password, the corresponding hint for your edit text and username. So now let's open your values directory and strings.xml file to create the strings so which we required in our application or layout creation. So click on open editor. I'm going to take it as the user. So the default one, I'm going to take it as username. Save this. One more for password. The value is password. And I'm going to give some hint. So it is not mandate now. Why? Because I'm going to go with a traditional login page, which we are not using presently in our real world. But actually, just to explain this concept, I'm taking such kind of thing. And I need some label for my button as well. One is login. Another one is for cancel. So I have created all string files, whatever I required. Just I'm going to refer this text view, which is already created for me. That is user. So save this automatically. It has been created. Now I need one edit text. So we already know. So give this as a wrap content. The height is also wrap content. And an edit text must require either a hint or input type. Here I'm not going to take any hint. Simply take input type. I'm going to take it as like a text person name or text email address. That is up to you. What do you take? Or simply take text as well. So save this. But if you observe here, it is completely very tiny and it is also overlapped. So for that, I'm going to take this in my linear layout. Why? Because I'm going to nested it. So take a linear layout. The width I'm going to take it as match parent, height as drop content, and place these two views, text view and edit text, between your linear layout. Now this is going to be placed, but the default, even though you don't give any orientation, default it will take horizontal orientation. So it is giving some warning saying that the linear layout is in its relative layout is useless because I did not provided any background or So I did not give any orientation. So just provide the orientation, set it as horizontal. Save this. If you observe here, this is what we have. But the problem is username edit is completely very tiny. If you put your mouse pointer in the preview, you can observe that. So for that, I'm going to use a weight concept, which we discussed in our previous sessions. Simply give the weight so as one. So save this. It has been occupied, the remaining one. So as when you are taking the horizontal orientation, the width must be 0 dp. So change your width to 0 dp. So now it has been created. Still it is giving some warning for me, like a linear layout or relative layout is useless. So that's all fine for now. It will be so cleared very soon. So after this, I need one more row. So the label is password and the corresponding edit text. So just simply to save my time, I'm copying this and create one more linear layout, put it here. Okay, so just change your labels. So string, this is for password and the corresponding label. If you observe here in the preview, one is overlapped with other, but the entire parent layout is relative layout. So the child. So I'm going to take the sibling relationship between these two linear layouts. So go and create an ID for this first linear layout. So give it as user ID. So let us say user ID, small. Okay, save this. Now where is the second linear layout must be below your first one. So just pass that value. Now automatically which it has been moved to the bottom. Means below your username row. And now I need two buttons. Just simply blindly add button to element to your layout. So I'm going to take it as a width as wrap content, height also wrap content. I need some label for my button. So take Android text is equals to, already I provided the string with a login. So the button has been created, and create one more button, the second button for cancel. So open up. Copy and paste this, change your label for the string as cancel, save it. But the both the buttons has been overlapped and moved to the top left corner as I am taking the parent relation now. But these two buttons must be below your second linear layout. Okay, so now create an ID for this. We already know how to create. So user ID plus, this is I am going to take it as password ID. Means the or else you can say password row instead of ID. Just take it as row. Let it make some sense. So change the ID to password row. Save this. And now I'm going to repo this row in my button. So just where this button must be below your password row. Okay. This login button has been moved, and just do the same thing for your second button as well. Save this. Now if you observe here, both are again overlapped, but at the below your password row. Now I want this can password login button to be to right side of the screen. So we already discussed this. What I'm going to take. So take your parent relation, align parent right. So make it as true. To save this, it has been moved to the second one to support right to left. So I'm going to use parent end as well. So add align parent end and make it true. So the warning has been cleared so far. Save this. Align parent end is true, better support. Yeah, okay. I already did this. Now come back here. This cancel button should be left hand side of your button. So come here to the button and create an ID for this button. At the right place ID, I'll say login button. Save this, and where this must be to left of your login button. Save this. It has been moved. At the same time to support right to left, I'm going to use to start off login button, save it. So this is how we'll create the layout inside a layout called as nesting of layouts. So that's all about nested layouts. Thanks for watching educators.com. Let's catch up in the next session.